Elohim titar mikoelo.
Every Shabbat in the Beit HaMikdash, they would switch the Lechem HaPanim on the Shulchan. Shabbat was also the time of the changing of shifts in the Beis HaMikdash, the Mishmarot Kehuna. Four Kohanim from the incoming Mishmeret, from the incoming shift, would walk into the Heichal. Two of them would each take a stack of six breads, and accompanied by the other two Kohanim, each holding a bowl, a bazich of Levona, they would all stand on the northern side of the Shulchan in the Heichal, while another four Kohanim from the outgoing Mishmeret would stand on the opposite side, the southern side of the Shulchan. While the Kohanim were sliding the new stacks of six breads each onto the Shulchan, the Kohanim from the outgoing Mishmeret were removing the previous week's bread from the Shulchan, and it was slid on and off simultaneously to satisfy the condition of Lechem Panim Lefanai Tamid. The Lechem HaPanim was a bracha of parnasa and shefa, and it had to be perpetually on the Shulchan 24/7 without interruption. Once they had removed the Lechem HaPanim, the 12 loaves, they would then distribute it between the two Mishmarot Kehuna. In the time of Beit Sheni, there were already approximately 250 Kohanim per Mishmeret, so the 12 loaves were being split between 500 people, which means that each Kohen actually only got a small portion of the Lechem HaPanim. But one of the miracles of the Lechem HaPanim was that it filled the Kohanim up as if they had eaten an entire meal, even though it was a small kezait. On the Shloshet HaRegalim, the Kohanim used to bring the Kelim out to show Am Yisrael, the menorah and the Lechem HaPanim, and Bnei Yisrael could see that the Lechem HaPanim was still warm. There was steam coming off of the Lechem HaPanim, another miracle that it had remained fresh the entire week that it was on the Shulchan, to show Kama Chavivim Am Yisrael were on HaKadosh Baruch Hu, how much he loved them. They say in the time of the Beit HaMikdash that there was such a degree of shefa that people only had to work for 2 hours every day to make a paranosa. Only 2 hours a day. The rest of the time they could spend studying Torah, spend time with their families. It was a degree of abundance that is unimaginable to us today. You should only be zoche be'ezrat Hashem to biyat HaMashiach. Yehi ratzon milfanecha, Hashem Elokeinu ve'Elokei Avotenu, שיזכו כהני עמך בית ישראל להחליף סדרים על השולחן מדי שבת בשבתו, במהרה בימינו, אמן.